Hi, my name is Linda with Pasha Snoring and Sinus Center. Today I'll be going over the process of home immunotherapy. Before doing any allergy shots, you are going to want to get your materials ready. You will need your dosing schedule, your allergy vial or vials, allergy syringes, as well as alcohol. In case of an adverse reaction, you are going to need your EpiPen or AUVI-Q, inhaler if you're asthmatic, anti-itching cream, as well as allergy pills. Next, I will show you how to measure your vial. First, you will have to make sure it is according to your dosing schedule. You're gonna hold your vial upside down. So let's say we are doing 0.05 today. You always want to draw back more than your actual dosage. Then you will be checking for big air bubbles. If there are any big air bubbles, you're gonna pull your needle out. You'll flick it, get all the air bubbles to the top, put it back into your vial, and then you're gonna dose it to your actual dosage just to make sure there's no air bubbles in there. If there's no air bubbles, you're ready for your injection. Next, I will show you how to do the injection. We are going to clean the injection site with our alcohol pad. Then we are going to pinch. The needle is going to go all the way in. And then we're going to want to pull back or aspirate. If there is no blood, we'll go ahead and do the injection. In the case that there is blood, we will not do the injection. You will pull the needle out, recap it, and dispose of it correctly. Get a new needle and redo the process. After the injection, you may develop soreness or redness on the injection site. That is normal. But in the case that you develop a very large knot, make sure you contact our office. If you develop a mild reaction, take an antihistamine, call our office, do not take your next dose, and have your EpiPen or AUVI-Q ready. Anaphylaxis is the most dangerous type of adverse reaction to our allergy program. The early symptoms are hives, tingling, rapid heart rate, sweating, nausea, and metallic taste inside the mouth. So in the case that you're developing any of these mild symptoms, you want to make sure you give yourself the EpiPen and then take yourself to the emergency room or call 911. As far as storing your vials, you want to make sure you keep them in your fridge and not your freezer side. You want to make sure you keep them in an area where if you open your fridge, they do not fall on the floor because they are glass and they will break. On your next new vial appointment, make sure you bring your EpiPen or AUVI-Q, your old vials, your old dosing schedule, and as a friendly reminder, please stay off of all allergy meds as well as sleeping meds 3 days prior to your next appointment.